Chair now declares this Congress a committee of the whole for the purpose of debating Virginia's resolution on independence.
Mr. Dickinson.
Well, now, you've got your way at last, Mr. Adams. The matter may now be discussed. And I confess I'm almost relieved. Well, there's a question I've been fairly itching to ask you. Why?
Why what, Mr. Dickinson?
Well, why independence, Mr. Adams?
Well, for the obvious reason that our continued association with Great Britain has grown intolerable.
To whom, Mr. Adams? To you? Well, then I suggest you sever your ties immediately. But please be kind enough to leave the rest of us where we are. For myself, I have no objection at all to being part of the greatest empire on Earth, to enjoying its protection and sharing its benefits.
Benefits? What benefits? Crippling taxes? Cruel repressions? Abolished rights?
Is that all England means to you, sir? Is that all the pride and affection you can muster for the nation that bore you? For the noblest, most civilized nation on the face of this planet? What would you have us forsake? Hastings and Magna Carta? Strongbow and Lionheart? Drake and Marlborough? Tudors, Stuarts and Plantagenets? For what, sir? Well, tell me, for what? For you? Some men are patriots, like General Washington. And some are anarchists, like Mr. Paine. Some even are internationalists, like Dr. Franklin. But you, sir? You are merely an agitator, disturbing the peace, creating disorder, endangering the public welfare. And for what? Your petty little personal complaints, your taxes are too high. Well, sir, so are mine. Come, come, Mr. Adams. If you have grievances, and I'm sure you have, our present system must provide a gentler means of redressing them, short of revolution. Yes, that's what he wants. Nothing less will satisfy him. Violence, rebellion, treason. Now, Mr. Adams, are these the acts of Englishmen?
Not Englishmen, Dickinson. Americans.
No, sir, Englishmen!